What's up, guys? Welcome to the new RockOn vlog. And today is a very, very special day for me and definitely also for you. As you can clearly see, we are in a special location with lots of legendary KTM bikes in the background that belongs to some KTM champions. And it's a very special bike behind me. And we are in the KTM Moto Hall. So today I'm gonna show you our craziest build so far. We really put blood, sweat and tears into that build off. And we created a brand new 2020 freestyle bike. It's under the curtain for now. That's not the only surprise for you. We have one dedicated surprise for you rockers. And enough of talking. So let me show you my new freestyle bike. Back in 2017, we built my first KTM Duke 250 stunt bike, and we changed a lot of parts and setup through the last years, but we needed to breathe a fresh air to it and adjust some stuff to bring my tricks to the next level. So that's the new bike, and let me show you what we did to it. First thing that definitely sticks out is the color of the bike. We went away a bit from the flashy colors and we decided for more darker tones. And we painted all the plastics in the gray color and then we created a sticker kit that fits to that background. So we went on the two-tone gray color and we still left some blue lines since this is part of our signature. Definitely some orange and definitely some RockOn pattern. And all that in matte finish, so it really fits perfectly. I really love that design and I'm already dropping the first big news. You can get that sticker kit for your bike. We made a replica sticker kit that fits perfectly to the orange base and the white base. So you can find this sticker kit on our online shop or in the description below and you can get that sticker kit for your Duke. The next thing that we customized were the rim edges and we painted them orange to round up the whole design. Since we went so crazy with the style of the bike, we didn't want to left out the seats this time. So we also pimped those ones and we added, as you can clearly see, a very nice neon orange stitching and we changed the materials so it has more grip when I jump around on the seat and it really looks dope, man. I really love the seats. Okay, let's do it like this. Dominic, tell me what is your favorite thing on the bike?
Besides the cool color, it's definitely the back wheel.
There is a lot of stuff on the back wheel.
It's the carbon plate.
Carbon, okay, probably a lot of you guys are watching already since we started that vlog on the back wheel, so let's move to the back. This is your favorite, right?
Yes.
the carbon plate. Yeah, with that idea, Zeitzmaster really blew my mind when he came up with that. And he took this inspiration from the superbike racing and the MotoGP bikes, where they use that for aerodynamics. But we use it here just for the style and also actually for the safety. In case I crash in a very weird way, I cannot hit or stuck my hand into the rear wheel. So it's also like a safety feature. But all in all, it looks dope. I really love that carbon plate. And thanks to Akrapovic guys, they actually make that carbon and cut them out with a laser cutter, and it really came out perfectly. It really fits as it should be. Since we're already here, let's continue to the brake setup. So for the next season, we changed my brake setup. In the past, I had a very big disc, 280 millimeters, and we went back to the stock size. We just added a racing brake disc from Motomaster, which really works perfectly on the high heat and the stress that I'm giving to the brakes. Then we added another brake caliper. That's actually the same what I had in the past. The difference is I'm now using a stock foot brake caliper, and all that, it makes the whole braking much smoother, and it's not so aggressive anymore on the slow tricks. So it really works perfectly. And we are using in both calipers sintered brake pads, so it gives me enough bite when I need it, but it's still not too aggressive because we have a smaller disc. That's my new brake setup, and I really love it. It's strong enough but still smooth. Hi chair! The next important part that we customized is the stunt tank. And what we did to it is we take the original one, we cut it away, and we welded a nice slate to it, and we designed a seat out of it so I can sit on it and stand on it. And on top of that, we have a grip tape so I don't slip away when I have shows in the wet conditions. So the stunt tank is a crucial part of each of our stunt bike builds. And this beautiful bike, it's a stunt bike, which means we're gonna have a lot of crashes, so we need to protect it. Let me show you how we did it. Oh man, I need to wake up, it's still early morning and we have so much parts of that bike. Whew. Okay guys, so as I said, protection. The setup that we use for protecting my bike is the adjustable subcage. As the name already said, it's adjustable, and it's from Bagarosh Performance, from my team. And the next thing is the front pegs. And another thing that we need to protect is the engine, is the KTM Power Parts clutch and engine cover, and it really works perfectly. When you destroy this CNC machine part, you can actually just replace it. So this is how I protect my bike, and it works really perfectly. I would really recommend to each of you to use a adjustable subcage and a KTM Power Parts or the engine covers or their crash cages. And if you have this combination, it really protects your bike perfectly. Next part, Dominic, where should we continue? Let's go to the handlebars.
On the left side, you see a lot of levers. On the bottom is my second rear brake, which is a standard to all the stunt bikes to control the tricks and the balance. And for that, I'm using the Magura HC1 13mm radial master. Above is the Bagarosh Performance Easy Pull Clutch. And I'm using both of those levers at the same time when I'm doing tricks. On the top is the second throttle or the idle control, so I can do the no-hand tricks and other acrobatic tricks where I don't need my hands on the handlebar.
Right side, I have a KTM adjustable brake lever, and it sits on the OEM brake pump. And to round everything up and make nicer, we used a bit of Bling Bling, KTM Power Parts CNC machined cover. All those controls sit on my Magura Rock Bagarosh handlebar. It's much stronger than the stock one. It has less back sweep, so it's more straighter. You have more control when you're doing tricks, and of course in a black finish. So this is my handlebar setup. Without a wheelie bar, there is no stunt bike, so that's why we have a wheelie bar on it. But no, I need it for stand on it. So we have a grip tape on it and also a scrape plate out of titanium for lots of sparks when I scrape on it. So yeah, that's the wheelie bar. Let's go to the next part. The whole bike sits on the Avon tires, and on the rear I'm using a 3D Ultra Sport, and on the front I'm using the Avon Spirit tire. cool looking bike needs also a cool sound, right? So Akrapovic exhaust again, as all on all my stunt bikes. Actually we didn't change a lot, or I would say we didn't change nothing on that exhaust, since we really made specifically for that engine a really cool and good working exhaust. It's just a fresh exhaust, it's a full system, it's not a slip-on. And if you want to see how we build that exhaust, you can click here, there is a vlog. So if you are a fan of weld porn, enjoy the vlog. If you watch our vlogs, you know that I'm using a 56 Buggers Performance sprocket for smoother wheelies, and I'm protecting my fingers in case of a crash so I don't cut them away with a toe guard. For my stoppy game, I need a very good front brake, and for that we upgraded the stock brake disc with a Motomaster disc. It's a 320 mm floating disc, and it looks wild, I know, and it also works like that. It really buys when you need it. And on top of that, we are using Motomaster sintered brake pads, and this brake setup proved itself in the recent 2 years that it works perfectly. Okay guys, that's my new 2020 stunt bike, and another sick stunt bike build is in the books, and I cannot wait to make the first show with that bike and to see the reaction of the people, and to see actually also the reaction, what you say about my stunt bike now on the YouTube. So drop some comments below what you think about it and what you would maybe change, or what you like on the bike. And that's not the end of the vlog, I have another big surprise for you. Are you ready? In 3, 2, 1, bam! You can guess what it is. It's a new year, which means we have a new design for the helmets. Let me show you how they look like. Okay, Dominic, which one first? The off-road or the street one?
The street.
Okay. Drum rolls, boom! Sick, right?
Oh yeah.
Do you see? Same, same.
Same, same, but different.
No difference, it's the same. And the off-road, drum rolls, ta-dum, boom. Brand new 2020 Rockon Scorpion XL helmets. The street helmet, the Scorpion XO 490 Rockon edition. It comes in a very nice matte finish, and it has the orange style to it. That means that it fits really perfectly to all KTM riders. You can add a nice tinted visor for a cooler look. It has also integrated sun visor in it. All the vents, so in the hot weather you can breathe better and have some fresh air in the helmet. And yeah, it just looks really amazing. Really, Scorpion XO outdone themselves. So that's the street version. So the off-road version, the Scorpion XO VX16 in Rockon style. It has a similar or the same style as the street helmet, with a nice Rockon leathering here, also orange, so it fits to your KTM motocross bike or a super motorbike. So even if you ride with an off-road helmet on a Duke bike, so I really love it. It has an adjustable visor, and what I really like is this system, the pump here, so you can pump your cheeks up so it fits perfectly. You can remove the inner lining and wash them when you sweat too much in the helmet. And yeah, all in all, I love that style too. It's for me hard to choose which one. Dominic, which one would you choose if you would ride a bike?
The off-road one.
The off-road one?
Yeah. For me it looks more rock and roll.
Okay. You want to have it?
I want to have a bike.
You
want to
have the bike. But do you have a driving license, or you have the same problem as Mariana?
Of course I have it.
You have? I'm not sure. Okay guys, that's not the last surprise. Since we are in a KTM Moto Hall, it's a very epic place, so they have some amazing bikes there. So let's go check them out, and let me show you the one last surprise for you. For all all that still don't know what KTM Moto Hall is, it's actually a brand new museum that opened its doors this year, and it's a perfect place for all the motorsport fans and definitely KTM fans, and you have a lot of cool stuff to see from its early beginnings of the KTM brand and the first bike that rolled out on the streets to the latest and newest off-road or street bikes. And one of the corners that I personally really like is this corner here, where we have prototype bikes that we always see on the big expos as a teaser what comes. And why is it so fun for me? Because here are two bikes that excited me for the KTM brand. Dominic, do you know this legendary bike?
Yes, I remember it.
It's a 125 Duke. Do you remember the prototype bikes? It was two bikes, actually. One was the race version, and do you remember the stunt version, the 125?
Just from the pictures.
It was kind of greenish, if I remember. Maybe you can play the picture in the vlog here. And exactly that bike made me so excited about the whole KTM brand, and it gave me the idea to go from the scooter stunts to a bike, and it was the perfect transition from a low CC scooter to a bit bigger, but not too big CC bike, so I can really learn the tricks step by step. And that was, do you remember the time when we first picked up the KTM bike, the 125 prototype? That was like in 2010 winter. Do you remember? It was a snowstorm outside.
Yes, and you trained in the winter.
True, so we needed to film a video how I pick up my first KTM bike, but it was a snowstorm outside, so we went to shoot in the factory itself. You can check the video right now. Memories, right? I mean, 9 years ago I was much younger and I had a wild haircut also. Just amazing memories. It makes me so proud to be a part of KTM family, and for 9 straight years. So next year we're gonna have 10 years that I'm a factory rider. So I'm super proud of me. I'm super proud of you, Dominic. We started together and we are still filming and traveling the world. So it's just amazing. It gives me chills when I talk about it. So this is the 125 Duke, and after 3 years, the 690 Duke came out. So that's a prototype, and they made a prototype based on a stunt bike. So it's a huge homage to stunt riders, and this makes me again super proud to be a stunt rider and to see a company that respects this sport and takes a lot of influence from our sport and to make this kind of cool bike. So let's enjoy some art shots of that bike. Prototype section to the street legal section. Actually, I'm standing to very awesome bikes. The early beginnings of the Dukes, that's the Duke 2. A few steps behind me is the Duke 620 that came out 1994. Maybe you know, maybe not, but it's 25 years of Dukes, and I'm super honored to be a big part of that progression and the history, the progression on the technology, progression on the style. Yeah, I always love that section too. Here you can see in the Moto Hall the first Duke, and to the last, the late Duke that it's out. So let's go over there where are the Dukes that I'm actually also riding in my vlogs. The new Duke range, from the Super Duke up to the 125 Duke, the Spawn Duke range got you covered. Doesn't matter if you want to travel short distances, long distances, or you want to hit some laps on the racetrack. You have a Duke for every type of rider. And this is what I also love on my Dukes. They are super light, they have perfect power distribution, smooth. I can make the tricks that I want. And do you remember I promised you a one more surprise? Let me show you what I got for you. To celebrate these 25 years of Dukes, we stick our heads together with KTM and I told them I want to make a very cool giveaway for our Dukers. So they said, Rock, no problem, let's do it. And they gave us to give away, be ready guys, this big KTM travel bag, this cool backpack, a cap, a shirt, the same one that I'm wearing in this vlog today, and a hoodie in the same style. So all you need to do is hit the subscribe button, share the vlog, and tell me what is your most memorable KTM experience, and if you don't own a KTM, which KTM would you like to have and what you would do with it. And we're gonna choose one winner out of top 10 most liked comments, and yeah, I hope I'm gonna see a lot of comments, and good luck to you guys. And we are on the end of the vlog, unfortunately, guys. So if you want also to come to the KTM Moto Hall and see the history of KTM bikes, you can find the link in description. That's it. I love my stunt bike. I need to go now to ride it, practice with it, get ready for the next season. So see you in the next one. Until then, rock on.